Let's create a snake game in JavaScript. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Gaspar and I will show you how to recreate famous computer games. The game I want to create this time looks like this. A simple snake game for which we only need 90 lines of JavaScript code. You can control the snake with the arrow keys and collect the food. At the top in the corner, the current score is displayed. Okay, we will start directly in the code editor, Visual Studio Code. First, I create a new folder, snake. Then we need a HTML file to display the game in the browser, index.html. In the HTML file, we need only two lines of code. First, a canvas with the ID field. This is the place where the game should be displayed in the HTML code. After that, I add the game code to the HTML document. We create the code in the file snake.js. So the second file we need is the file snake.js. As soon as the index file is called in the browser, the code of this file here is executed with the first function. I start like always with the variables. Var size equals 500, which is the size of the playfield. Grid size equal size by 50. With var field document get element by ID field, the ID field from the HTML file is referenced, where we placed the code, which should be displayed in the browser. With field height, the resolution is doubled. So it looks nice on high resolution displays. With var ctx, field get context 2D, we can have graphics drawn on the field. Ctx stands for context. The context is also scaled. The variable direction defines the direction in which the snake can be moved. The snake gets a start length of 5. Var snake sets the start position of the snake for the x and y coordinates. Thus, the game starts in the middle. Then we need food. A variable if the game is over, and a score with a start value 0. Okay, now it's time for the functions. With the function randomFood, the food is created at a random place on the game field. The function tick runs as long as the game is active. The snake part is composed of an x and y object. Only if the direction has a different axis, then the direction should be changed. x stands for 1 or minus 1, and y means 2 or minus 2. If the direction is less than or equal to 0, then move to the left or down. Otherwise, move to the right or up. Now we check if the head of the snake is on the same cell as the foot. Did the snake eat the food? If so, food is set to 0 again. Then the length of the snake is increased by 10. Here you can also make up any value you want. Also the score is increased by 1. After that, I want to define what happens when the game is over. First, I choose the background color of the game field. A dark blue. The whole field should be painted with a square that starts at the x and y position 0 and covers the whole field with size and size. When the game is over, then a text is output in a bright yellow. The font should be 30 pixels with the font Monospace. The text should be displayed in the middle of the screen. As text, I choose in the first line Game Over. Score with the score. In the second line I write space to continue. If the key code 5 is triggered, then the whole game should be reloaded. 5 stands here for the space key. We will create the function for the key control later further down. Else, if the game is not over yet, then a new part is added to the head. Also, the maximum snake length is enforced. Next, the score color is set. I choose a bright yellow again. The font size is 20. And the text is called score at the position 5 and 20. Now I want to check how the game can end. For example, we check a collision with the walls. If the snake touches one of the walls, then end equals true. I want to draw the snake in a light green. the snake objects are cached in an array. In a for loop, the total length of the snake is stored in the variable a. The next line draws the snake. The minus 1 means that the squares are drawn a bit smaller than the grid, so that these gaps between the squares are created. You can play around with the values to see what is prettier for you. Next, I want to build a collision lockup object. Here I have to add the coordinate to string function above. The function does exactly what the name says. It returns the coordinates from the objects in x and y as a string, separated with a comma. I use the function directly in the next line to check if the snake touches itself. If this is the case, the game stopped again. A while loop always creates new food if there is no more food. Coordinate to string again ensures that the food is not created on the snake. The food is then placed at a random x and y coordinates. So the next three lines draw the food. First, a color. For this, I choose a bright yellow. Then the food is created using the coordinates from the food and the size from the grid size. This draws a square foot. As an alternative, I show you a variant with circles. Finally, you have to add the function that starts automatically when the window is loaded. The tick is given in milliseconds. 100 means that the field is redrawn every 0.1 seconds, so 10 times per second. This line starts the game looping. With window on key down, the control of the snake is set. The key codes are set codes on the keyboard. -37 is the left arrow key. Left is converted to -1 in the game. 38 means up on the keyboard. In the game, up is -2. 39 and 1 means right. And 40 and 2 means down. Finally, the key to restart the game. The key code 32 controls the space key. I use the 5 in the code above. Okay, that's it. The code is ready. As always, you can find the complete code to copy and follow on my GitHub page. The link is in the description. Finally, I start the game by opening the index file with the browser. Very nice, there is a finished snake game in 90 lines of code. If you liked the video, I would be happy about a like. Thank you for watching and happy coding!